Good, very cruel, because if Pharaoh continued to do good, then these people will continue to stay in Egypt. Then the promise of God will not come to pass for them to go back to Canaan. Remember, the first Pharaoh gave them the best place in Egypt, that place called Goshen. That is the best place in Egypt, was given to Joseph, because Pharaoh was very happy. He was overjoyed with the talent and the gift and the knowledge and the wisdom in Joseph. So he said, go and get your father, get everybody, tell them to come here. I'll give you the best of Egypt. Hallelujah. So when they continued to multiply, hallelujah, until the Pharaoh came and changed them and told them, okay, you are not Egyptian. Hallelujah. You are from Abraham and Isaac and then Jacob. It was because of Joseph that you came here. Of course, the people in Egypt, they will know the history. So they were taking over in most of the position in the government, the district, because they are very smart people, because they are serving their God. So the time will come that they told them to go to number two class, or class number two of citizenship. Hallelujah. Because they are owners of the land. And these people, because of Joseph and because of that Pharaoh, now they're taking over. Hallelujah. They're taking over every part of Egypt. The fattest part of Egypt, they are there. Every position in the government, they are there. Every position in tradition, culture, they are there. And they are very powerful. They are workers. That's when they were taken into slavery. People start to kill their children. Every child that is below 2 years old will be killed. They were trying to eliminate them. Hallelujah. You know, so many leaders in the world, they've said to the Israelites, you're not supposed to be succeeding. You're not supposed to be in existence. You're supposed to be wiped out from the planet. You know, some big, great leaders, they already said that. Anwar Sadat, Colonel Gaddafi from Libya, Ayatollah Khomeini from Iran, even Alexander the Great. You talk about Cyrus and you talk about Nebuchadnezzar. There are so many leaders before and even today. In the 21st century, we have Saddam Hussein. Hallelujah. There are so many people, leaders of the great nation. They want to eliminate the Israelites. Hallelujah. But because God already set them apart, then he said, you are my people. You are the descendants of Abraham, my friend. Hallelujah. I will keep my word to your forefathers, to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. So when the Pharaoh came, the fifth or the sixth Pharaoh, he changed them, put them into prison, and make them slave. And that's when, hallelujah, Moses came into power. So obedience to the leaders, because all leaders are put there for his purpose. Nebuchadnezzar was there, so he can take the Israelites to be slave again in Babylon, because they were in Zion, but they were worshipping idols. Solomon have about 1,000 wives. So all the wives, they will come with their God. So in Jerusalem, there are so many foreign gods, small g. Hallelujah. So Nebuchadnezzar came and took them. God said to Jeremiah, Jeremiah, tell them, I alone knows the plan I have for them. Plan to prosper them, never to harm them. So God is in control. When we are here in Fiji and we're going through this pandemic, going through yesterday the highest ever on the positive, 105. God is in control. We are paying our disobedience. As I said before, in the middle of May, I request a lot of people in authority to stop drinking kava, to stop the drinking. Because when you stop that, you stop the three things that must be stopped immediately, to be banned, to be made as a law. One is smoking, one is drinking kava, and one is drinking alcohol. If we have done that in the second week of May, we